Did you know that one of the single biggest contributors to water pollution is a naturally occurring nutrient called phosphorus? Plants need phosphorus to grow, but it can create big problems if it enters the environment in high doses. Today, many Minnesota water bodies have unnaturally high levels of phosphorus. Where is it coming from? Leaf litter and sand from city streets are both important sources of phosphorus when they wash into rivers and lakes. But would you guess that another source is actually dogs?
You ready?
That was one surprising conclusion of scientists from the University of Minnesota who are seeking to better understand how chemicals like phosphorus, nitrogen, and carbon cycle through our homes and yards.
Pets, and particularly dogs, you feed them food, so we import some nitrogen and phosphorus in the form of food, and they eat it, and then they go out and defecate in the yard. It's pretty much the same thing as taking the dog food and just dumping it into the yard.
Pets pollute through the waste they leave in yards, parks, and elsewhere, because pet waste contains high levels of phosphorus. When this phosphorus gets into rivers and lakes, it can cause problems like too much algae growth, which can choke out fish life. Because of this, the state of Minnesota restricted the use of phosphorus as a lawn fertilizer several years ago. But high levels of phosphorus are still making their way into our rivers and lakes, and one source of that extra phosphorus may be pet droppings.
The food that we feed our pets is going to end up in the landscape somehow when our pets, you know, do what pets do. And so what happens to that phosphorus ultimately depends on what we do with the pet waste. If that pet waste is deposited on the boulevard where it's close to the storm sewer, it could potentially easily be washed into the storm sewer during a rain event. If that pet waste is deposited along the banks of a river, it could easily be moved into lakes and streams. So there's higher potential for that phosphorus to have a negative environmental impact.
And particularly for people who have multiple pets and for people who don't clean up, it really makes an argument for cleaning up after your pets.
So the next time you take your dog out for a walk, think about the footprints that Fido is going to leave in more ways than one.